Hello everyone, this is Ankita Rani and in this video I will continue with the modal verbs. My next modal verb is out to. Actually, with the help of out to, we can do many things. Like the first one is it expresses moral obligation or social obligation. So let me tell you, you must till now you are aware with the word obligation. What is obligation? Obligation is, you know, duty, right? So whenever you need to express moral obligation and social obligation, you can use out to. So let me just tell you, what is moral obligation? What do you mean by moral obligation? What is social obligation? Actually, moral obligation, when you fulfill your moral duty, because obligation is duty, right? When you fulfill your moral duty, you will be called as a person with good character. And you know, what is social obligation? That what is good, what is right for society and what is wrong for society. So we should fulfill that duty. Okay, so moving to the examples, let's just take the first example. We out to help the poor, right? Here I have written out to. So it's like a social obligation. It's the expression of social obligation that, you know, we should help the poor. Whenever we see a poor, according to, you know, social norms, that we should help that person so that he can, you know, fulfill his needs. So here I have written, just to express the social obligation, out to. Okay, moving to the next example. You ought to respect your elders, right? In this sentence, a moral obligation is being, you know, expressed. Why? Because, you know, I'm telling that you ought to respect your elders. So you when you respect your elders, you will be like a person with good character. You will be known as a, you will be called as a person with good character. So here I have written out to, you know, express this moral obligation, moral duty. So it's your moral duty to respect your elders, then, you know, you will be known for your good character. Okay, I think you have understood this much. Okay, moving to the next usage. It expresses probability or guess. Okay, with the help of, you know, out to, we can express guess and probability, definitely. So moving to the example likes petrol prices out to rise soon, right? When I say this petrol prices rise out to rise soon, it means I'm guessing that, you know, with seeing the present scenario, you know, there is a probability that petrol prices may get hiked, right? It may get raised. So in this way, I am expressing the, you know, guess or probability. Okay, now my next modal verbs is used to. Actually, let me tell you one thing before going to the usage of used to and all. Actually, there are three modal verbs: used to, need, and there. Actually, these three are not fall under the category of modal verbs, but it belongs to the category of marginal modal. That is also known as semi models, because, you know, in the first video of modal verbs, I have discussed that thing, that auxiliary verbs are of three types. So modal verbs is one of them, and marginal auxiliaries are the second one, right? And the first one is primary modal. So these are the three types of auxiliary. So used to falls under the category of semi-modal, that is also known as marginal, or you can say that it's semi-modal. That's why I have, you know, taken to that's why I've chosen it to, you know, discuss the use of, because it's also known as semi-modal. Okay, so let's just begin with the usage. It expresses a habit which has been discontinued. Actually, with the help of used to, we can express a habit which has been discontinued. Meaning is to, in past I was habituated with certain kind of habit, but now that thing has, you know, stopped, you know. Now let me take the example so that the things will become more clear. Now I'm saying that there used to live a magician in certain, you know, village, in certain town. There was a magician who used to live there, right? Like we can also express like I used to live in that city, I used to live in that, I used to go there, right? So it is showing that you, the thing is happening in the past, but not, you know, it has stopped happening in the present scene, present time. So in this way we can express a habit which has been discontinued. I used to smoke when I was a boy. So here what I have written, that when I was a boy I used to smoke, but now I have stopped smoking, right? That, you know, habit I have written, don't think that here it's not a habit. It's like a, you know, something it expresses a something that, you know, activity which used to happen, you know, past, but not going on, right? Going on in the present. So that's why. So don't take it in a narrow sense habit, that okay, this will fall under this example, second example will fall under the habit, but this first one is not. That's why, you know, don't take it in a narrow sense. Okay, now moving to the next, you know, semi-modal, that's a semi-modal verb. So the usage is, the next is need. Okay, the need is used for expressing need, as the name suggests, need. So whenever we need to express that necessity, right, a duty, we can express the, we can use the need. I need to go, it means actually I'm in need to go because I have some work to do, right? So I need to go, I'm expressing the necessity, requirement, that what is essential now. I need hardly take his advice. See, you know, it means that it's like a negative expression. I don't want his advice. So I need hardly take his advice. I can do without taking his advice. So that's why, you know, it's written, I need hardly take his advice. Right? It's like requirement. Need, you can say in other word, need is requirement. Yes. Okay, moving to the next semi-modal. It is used for expressing negatives and interrogatives. See, as you all know this word there, what is there, right? So you can express, you know, you can write, you can use it as a semi-modal in when you express it in a negative and interrogative. Like, she dare not make me angry, right? So whenever, it means that she should not dare to make me angry, right? It's, she dare not make me angry. This sentence is in a negative, and this, the second one is, how dare you shout on me, right? There is, you know, audacity, right? So the second one is in a interrogative. So I think I have completed all the modal verbs and, you know, semi-modal, whatever it is. So I think in next video I will take some other topic, and, you know, I have completed the modal verbs in this till now. So in the next video I will take some other topic, start the other topic. Till then, bye and thanks for watching my video.